It hasn't been difficult, but not for me, because I am primarily an actress. I started 37 years ago in show business as an actress. But I think that probably in the last few years, it's probably been rather difficult for the general public to accept me as an actress when I appear doing character roles, such as playing a dreadful old witch in a thriller series and a woman who ran a house of werewolves and Hammer House of Horror and things like that, because people seem, they in fact know me as Diana Dawes, as I am today, and it's difficult for them to sort of see me in some character role, unlike a really great actress like Betty Davis or an actor such as Alec Guinness, who is not really a person that they know immediately. They know Alec Guinness as a brilliant character actor and therefore accept all those character roles that he plays. And it's not easy for them to suddenly take Diana Dawes with all this blonde hair and the diet and the whole nonsense that goes on with me and accept me as an actress in some role. Bear in mind, you never was able to boast of too many sex queens, so how did it come about that you really were the answer, the British answer to the Marilyn Monroe figure? Well, I think it was because I was the first, and to be the first of anything is always good. Indeed, I have a very old press cutting at home somewhere tucked away in a film magazine called Picture Gun, which was around in the early 50s. Some people are
here. I think too many of them remember.
Somebody wrote to Picturegoer just after Marilyn Monroe had done one of her first films called The Asphalt Jungle, in which she had a very small role. And this person wrote to Picturegoer and said, how much like our own Diana Dawes this new Marilyn Monroe is in America, which is interesting. So it was inevitable that I would always be compared with her. And indeed, when I went to Hollywood for the first time, of course, the Americans had never heard of me other than doing a Bob Hope television special. They thought that I was just some British blonde who had aped Marilyn Monroe and just climbed onto her bandwagon, which of course was not true. And that took a lot of living down. In fact, I don't think I've really ever lived it down in America. They still regard me as Britain's answer. That's what they used to call me, Britain's answer.
But when you were being, you know, built up as this symbol, was there a lot of sort of publicity stunting going on, that kind of thing?
Well, there were an awful lot of publicity gimmicks in those days. It was part and parcel of the film business. Sadly, we have no film business. Many films being made then, and it was up to everybody to instill a bit of light entertainment and glamour and amusement for the British public, because we had really taken so many years to get over the war, and by 1952-53 we were only just out of rationals and all those things. So when somebody like myself came along, they'd never seen a blonde, they never had a blonde in this country before. So up to then it was always the American film that had had the monopoly of blondes, like Betty Grape, Carol Landis, Mae West, and so on. And so I, as I say, was the first, and it was good because the British public looked at me rather like they used to look at naughty seaside postcards.